Welcome everyone here in the Open Lab in the site of Bergamo, and here to present you the ATS main timing solution. Starting from presenting myself, I'm Paolo Chiesa. I'm working here in the Open Lab and I'm a testing engineer of electronic devices.
Hi everybody, again, it's Roberto Zanardi here. As Paolo, I'm a test engineer in this lab in Bergamo. And let's see how to install the ATS main timing closed transition solution.
Before to install, I will ask to Roberto to present the hardware that we are using and that you will need it for to implement this logic in the devices.
So, what you are looking right now is a totem where we installed four PIP units from our IMAX2 breaker. So of course you cannot see the entire breaker here, but only the trip unit, the electronic part. But in terms of functionality, they feel to be connected to the real breaker, because inside each of these rack, we have all the connection that the trip unit has inside the real breaker. So we can simulate the opening and the closing of the breaker. We can see the reactions, so the trip in case of protection trip. And also we have some output directly connected on the front. And then on the back, we have all the connection that the customer has inside their panel. So about the auxiliary supply, the communication, and all the other output and inputs of our modules. And then, the only thing that we need to do to install the solution, the ATS solution, is just to connect our laptop to each trip unit and see what Paolo is gonna show with the KeepConnect 3 software.
Yes, thanks Roberto. So first of all, I need to connect my laptop that I have here to the breakers. There are two main ways to connect the laptop. The first one, the most common one, is by the KeepTMP, so it's a BB connector, a USB connector, and we will use this one for this kind of test. Another solution that is by using the Ethernet cable, but it's mandatory to have the Modbus TCP module inside all the circuit breaker. In our case, since it's for the sake of simplicity, we will use the KeepTMP. So Roberto can connect to the USB port that every circuit breaker has. Then we can move to the software, and here there is the main page of the KeepConnect. You can see there are many ways to connect to the devices. As I told you, we will use the TMP. So we'll do the scan, and after a while my computer will be able to read all the information and to set all the settings that I need inside the circuit breaker. So let's talk about the ATS main timing tool that we need to implement. I can go directly in the page of tools, but this kind of solution is not free. So you need to buy, first of all, the license from the marketplace page. So for this one, there will be a specific video in which we will explain you how to buy the licenses. We are in the second step, in which we have already this license, and I can go in the My Device page. And here you can see I have ready for activation the load shedding adaptive tool, for example, or the ATS main timing close. In this case, since my device is already connected, I can go in the tools page. In the tools page, here we have a different kind of tool, but we are just interested now in the embedded ATS, in particular in the main timing close transition. So we will select this one. Here is the topology of the network in which we have. We must have three circuit breakers, of course, with their own condition and also some particular settings. Remember, very important, because it's a common mistake, before downloading any logic to each of the breaker, you need to set all the settings for the entire system. So let's see for each label that we have here what we need to do. If I click on main time main close transition, I have the parallel time. Remember that for everything that you don't know what is it exactly, you can just press the info button and you have the explanation. This one is quite easy to understand, is the parallel when you have the two sources. In this case, it has a range from 300 milliseconds to 10 seconds. I can just drag and drop here as much as I want. For example, we select, I don't know, 1 second of delay. Then I can select the main breaker 1 label. Here you can see that we have opening time after voltage below threshold. As I told you, just check if you need to know what is exactly. But the name is quite clear, I think. Here I have from 0 to 60 seconds, I will select, I don't know, for example, 4 seconds, okay? 2 seconds. Then I will move to main breaker 2. For the main breaker 2, the same operating time after voltage threshold, and I will select the same delay for the sake of test. This one, this kind of values has to be defined from the user. So in your case, you, or in this case, we will decide this condition. Then the last label is the bus tie. I will click and I have another parameter, it's time before bus tie close. In this case, from 2 to 10, I will select, I don't know, 3 seconds. Okay, so these are all the main settings that I can set in the ATS main timing tool. So quite easy to say. Now we just need to transfer this parameter to each of the circuit breaker. So, for example, I make the scan to the breaker that I decide according to my topology of the network, in this case of the totem, that this breaker is the main breaker 1. So we'll go back in the main breaker 1 page, label. You can see that there is another condition, is role association. So say, what is the real breaker? Here, the TMP is saying, okay, I'm seeing this kind of breaker with this specific serial number, that is the serial number of the mainboard, and the Q1 is the tag name. So for you, it can be easy to recognize the real device by checking this information. Then I will just press on this option, and then you can see that now I have the KeepTouch Black Q1 as main breaker 1. Pay attention, the TMP is a 1x1 connection. So I cannot just go now in main breaker 2 and connect them, because you can see there are no breakers available because the other one is already busy as main breaker 1. So until now I have to download the logic to this breaker, and then we will do the same for the other two breakers. So how can I can download the logic to the main breaker 1? I have to press the transfer, but before I need to check the last part. Here I have the role association, as I told you, there is the role condition. Let's see what is the role condition. The role condition is checking if all the hardware are correct, so if you have all the requirement that the ATS needs, and so on. So let's see here what is the results. You can see that if I have the green light, it means the TMP that is connected to the device say, okay, I see the keep link, for example, or others. But you can see here, I don't have something particular. In this case, it's the keep syncer check. So I don't have it here in the device. And it means that the logic will not work in this case. But if I say, okay, I don't care, for me, the syncer check is useless, I want to download it in any case, I will press transfer. The transfer here, the first one is the warning that is saying we are programming a lot of stuff. If I go on, click on yes, here is showing me this error, say transfer not available. The following conditions are missing main breaker 1. You can see that here I was missing some important information, the synchro check and also the mechanical condition, I didn't check them. So the logic cannot be transferred. So for you, that maybe is the first time that you are using this, it's very useful to see which are the real hardware and the packages that you must have are all here shown in the tool. Roberto, maybe you can show directly the hardware that we are missing.
So about the hardware, Paolo was saying that the keep synchro check is missing. The keep synchro check is a module that can be mounted directly on the EMAX2 breaker. And as you can see here, we do have the keep com Modbus TCP, the keep link, and the signaling 2K1. Of course, we cannot mount the keep synchro check here because all the spaces are full. Need to disconnect one of these modules, it will be the Eclipse Signaling 2K1, which is not needed for the ATS. And then we will connect the Keep Simple Check module which is available in our rack and it is here. About the mechanical module needed, so the opening, closing coil, the motor operator and so on, the Keep Connect cannot realize if they are directly connected to the breaker because they are not an electronics module. The customer needs to check them manually on the Keep Connect as Paolo was showing before. So this part about the electronic modules can be checked directly by the Keep Connect software automatically, and the Keep Simple Check was missing and we checked it. The mechanical part the Keep Connect cannot check. So it cannot check the mechanical part, so the customer need to check if the modules are present, so the opening, closing coil and so on. So I disconnected the Keep Signaling to K1 and I connected the Keep Synchro Check to the Trip Unit. So Paolo now can go on with the transfer of all the settings.
Yes. So let's move here again in the roll condition and let's see. Now you can see that there are all green lights. As Roberto say, I have to check the manual condition. So in this case, Keep Connect will trust you. Okay, so is your problem if it doesn't work, if you make a mistake. So now the roll condition are checked, so we just need to transfer it inside the circuit breaker. So here the transfer button, as already told you, here the first warning about the programming that will be downloaded inside the circuit breaker. I will confirm and then here I say okay, there is a license that you need to activate inside your device. I have already bought the license from the marketplace. I say yes. And now, as you can see, the tool is downloading all the settings or information that I decide inside the breaker. It's quite quick, as you can see. Here I said the transfer complaint say main breaker 1 transfer success, the other failed, not because there was an error but because there wasn't any kind of connection, of course. When you will do that, for example, the transfer by using the Ethernet cable, in this case you can see all the three breakers at the same time, you will not just need to do one transfer because you can see all the three at the same time, so download all the logics in parallel. So what we have to do now is to unplug the USB cable from the main breaker 1 and move to the main breaker 2. In our case it will be the second circuit breaker. And then we move again to a Keep Connect. Remember, it's important to scan it again. So we'll make the scan TMP in this case of the breaker.
If you are familiar with the breaker, you maybe have noticed that if you connect to a breaker and then disconnect to that and connect to another, if they are of the same family, the Keep Connect can still get the measurement and enjoy communication with the new breaker. But it's always better to do a new scan, as Paolo was saying, because you refresh all the data and you are sure that you are really connected to the new one and the data you are going to set are related to the new one. So always when you disconnect and connect to another, press again the scan button.
That is very important. So now let's go back in the Keep Connect. I'm connected to the breaker, main breaker 2, in this case the name is Q2. We can go back in tools, it's already open the page. As you can see, the main breaker 1, the serial number is still there because it has already connected to something. So we select main breaker 2, we'll do again the role association and I have the new one with the new serial number. And then remember, it's always mandatory to check the role condition. Everything is green, so I can do the manual condition check and then repeat again the transfer procedure. It will be always the same condition. For example, in this case, you can see that there is already a license connected to this device because maybe you are doing again another update of the logic. It's not a problem, just refresh it. You will make a kind of upgrade of the settings and so on. So now we are downloading for the main breaker 2 and we are just missing the tie breaker. One important advice that I want to highlight is never change anything of the settings while you are doing the transfer or between the devices. As you can see, Breaker 2 transfer success. So now let's repeat again the procedure. Roberto is moving in the third one. Then we can go back again in the Keep Connect, make the scan, but it wasn't well connected. Okay, it's connected to this breaker that is called CBC. And then we can go in Tools again. You can see we have the two breakers already programmed. We are just missing bus tie. Bus tie, role association, we have the last one, CBC with its own serial number. And then role association and transfer. Yes. Again about the license, say yes. Now, from the Keep Connect point of view, so from the logic download, here is success, the game is done. So it means when you are on the field, you have finished the programming part. So the ATS is already working, you don't have to change anything. So now we can see the real behavior of the ATS.
So now the ATS solution is installed on each breaker, so main breaker 1, main breaker 2 and the tiebreaker. We did it one by one by using the Keep TMP link and TMP and connected directly on each breaker. What we were talking about before, so one only download for all of them, is not about the Keep TMP connection, which is one by one, but it's about the TCP connection, so the Ethernet connection. I mean that we have a Modbus TCP module installed on each the breakers. If you can connect your laptop to the same network of the TCP modules, so of the breakers, you can scan the Ethernet connection of the Keep connector, recognize all three the breakers together, and then set the ATS logic as Paolo did on each breaker, and then press only one time the transfer button. So that's the difference between the Ethernet connection and the TMP connection. But then as a matter of functionality, that's the same for the automatic transfer switch. Another part that we didn't see, but it's really important on this setup, is that we talked about the trip unit, the electronics. We don't have the real breaker, but we do have all the connection of a real breaker. What we can do also with a setup like this is to generate currents, voltages, signals, connecting directly to each of the breakers. Those voltages and currents are connected directly to the breaker, to the trip unit. So we can generate the voltage and current signals and connect them directly to the secondary side of the sensor that are mounted on the real breaker. So the trip unit, it's not connected to the sensor, but the value coming from the sensor on a real plant are generated by our setup, by LabVIEW and an electronic device that we have installed inside the totem. So from a trip unit point of view, they recognize the signals coming as the real one on the plant. And that's why, if you can see, and maybe we can zoom on the screen of the device, we are right now, actually, we are reading currents and voltages. So they are not fake values because of the software installed, but they are pretty real values generated in our setup here and connected directly to the trip unit. And this is the way that we can now show and test also the functionality of our automatic transfer switch. So if we move back to a general view of the setup, you can see that we have a screen on the top, which is the panel where we can change and set all the value of these current voltages and so on, and also we can generate faults or whatever. So what we are going to do here now is to test this automatic transfer switch. Let's talk about the starting situation. We have main breaker 1 closed with voltage coming from the grid of the main breaker 1 side. Then we have main breaker 2 closed with voltage coming from the grid connected to the main breaker 2. And the tie breaker is open because our loads, which are shown down here, are energized by main breaker 1, these two, and main breaker 2, the other two. What happens if we have a fault coming on the grid 1 side, for example? I click on the grid and I can change the value of the voltage of this side. For example, we have a loss of voltage or just an under voltage on this part of the grid. I disconnected the voltage, so main breaker 1 is now opened. It took some seconds for the tiebreaker to close. Those seconds are the one that we set before with Paolo. It was about 3 seconds, I can't remember actually the value, but those are the seconds that the customer can actually install inside the trip unit. What happened then when the voltage is back to the normal value on the grid? As you can see now, the grid is lighted up. Main breaker 1 is still closed. What we need to do to reconnect. So we had the fault on the grid number 1, but now the voltage is back to life, and you can recognize the grid which is lighted up. In this configuration, we can close again the breaker of the grid number 1. As you can see, now the 3 breakers are working and using the SynchroCheck module, they are checking the voltage of all the sides of them. In fact, as you can see, we have the internal voltage, frequency and delta phase, which are agree with the external voltage, frequency and phase. This means that now the synchronism is okay, and you can recognize the okay here. That means that we can open up again the tiebreaker and close the grid 1 breaker. So for doing that, we need to move. So as you can see, now the grid 1 is back to life. We have the voltage again. I switch to the manual, which means that our breaker can realize that they are working in a manual configuration. Now I can close again the breaker 1 of the grid 1. For doing that, I'm in manual, I need to select the tiebreaker and click open command of the tiebreaker. We will see that the main breaker 1, so the breaker of grid 1, is closing, and then after the parallel time, my tiebreaker can open. So let's do that. Okay, so main breaker 1 is now closed and the tiebreaker is open. If we go back to the automatic configuration, you can see that we have a green light about the ATS reading. It means that the automatism is working. If we switch to manual, of course, the ATS is no more ready, and you can recognize that not only here in our scenario, but also on the breaker by looking at the output of the breakers. For example, now we are in a situation where the ATS is not ready because we are in manual configuration. If I switch to automatic configuration so that the ATS is ready, I have an output 1 closing. It means that the automatic transfer switch is now enabled.
To know all these things about the input of the 4K is enough just to check in the catalog. In the white paper, you have the electrical scheme, and you can check, for example, if you need to know if you are in manual, for example, or you are in emergency condition and others, just cross-check the electrical scheme. In fact, pay attention on, for example, on this panel that we have here. Here we have the logic off, the emergency button, and so on. These are our graphical stuff. When you will buy the ATS license and so on, this one is an additional stuff that we create for this one. We just follow the electrical scheme, connect them as the logic requires. You cannot just try to imagine where you want to connect. You have to follow what the electrical scheme is telling you. Okay. In general, the logic works in this way. There are some additional particular conditions that maybe we can explain you quickly. For example, Roberto said before, if you lose a voltage from one of the two mains, it will go, if you are in automatic mode, you are in the okay condition of the synchro check, it will close the tie breaker and so on. But for example, that is the most common condition that you can have is maybe you have to go there on the transformer and make some change of the transformer. So you need to power off the transformer. So there's not a problem in the network, you just need to switch it off. So if you need to disconnect the network from one of the two mains, for example main generator one, the transformer or whatever, so you need to open this circuit breaker, CBA in our case, in our condition. In this case, the condition, the operating mode has to be manual, of course, and then I want to send a command that will let the main breaker one opens, and also the tie breaker, I want that it will close, so we'll have always the continuity of service. So, in this case, I'm in manual condition, the synchro check is in okay condition, I will send, I have to select CBA, because I want to open CBA, and then I will press the button of the opening command. For a while, I had the parallel, and then the CBC, close, okay? And this condition works every time that you need. Okay, so now if I want to go back in the normal condition, I will do again, I will select CBC and press the open command of CBC and will close CBA. You don't need to go directly on the field and press the open button of the circuit breaker, but you just need this small panel, say, okay, I want to open this, so just press a button, the logic will do all this work for you. Last but not least is the logic off condition, that is the emergency button, that is a normally closed button. So if you need to switch off the logic because open the both of the breaker, or I need to close the tie breaker for one particular reason that now we don't care, I can just press the button that we have here. The button will turn off one of the input of the four signaling 4K, and then I can open and close all the circuit breaker manually or whatever. In this case, all the automatic transfer switch will not work. When I will do all the stuff and finish, I will just remove the emergency button, and then I can go back and set the ATS logic as it was before. So that's all for now for the ATS main-to-main close transition. We hope that it was a bit clear according to all the conditions that you need. For additional information, don't worry to ask to me and Roberto, and you can cross-check the behavior on the white paper. Thank you all.
Thank you.